Mrak Small was Vice Chancellor of Business and Finance first under Chancellor Mrak, then under Chancellor Meyer, 1964 to 1978.
Well, you've had successes, and I suppose you've had problems at times. You want to highlight any of successes? You've hired people who have stayed on, and
during those days, I found out rather quickly in the position I was in, and purchasing. We get these calls all the time from the department. Now, the accounting would get them all the time. What's the policy on this? What's the policy on that? Purchasing would be the same way. The business people in the department had nothing to tell them what the policy was. And they'd call their counterparts and try to get what's the answer to this one, what's the form we use, and so forth. It took a lot of time to answer those questions. Then I found out that the university hall would write a policy and send it down to each of the campuses. It would get Xerox and sent out to the departments. As well as the poor department business manager or administrative assistant would have all these letters from university hall saying, here's a policy on this purchasing matter or this personnel matter or space, all this. There was just no central place to look it up. So I came up with the idea that what the campus needs is what in the Army we used to call a set of Army regulations. Go anywhere, and you'd have these regulations tell you what the policy is and how to do it. So I thought it'd be good to start them at the university and gather all these things into them. Well, we did, and I think it was a big help.
Procedures manual,
policy and procedures manual, it became, and it's still in existence. We write them up now in the chancellor's office. Because of the policy, he either decides or he gets from the university hall and goes into the manual. And the administrative people in the departments can look it up. It saved a lot of wasted time.
So then, 5 or 6 years after you arrived, Emil Mrak retired and Jim Meyer became the chancellor. How did things change as you saw administration in Mrak Hall with the arrival of a new chancellor? And how did that affect what you were doing as a vice chancellor?
Well, as far as Jim was concerned, of course, he was very management-oriented. More up-to-date than I was on the latest theories and books and so forth that have to do with administrative management. And this is where you began to get on the campus advisory committees. And the decentralization, so you could be the department chair
and so forth. To the deans and then turn to the
chairs. And then even the campus, the chancellor's office became a little bit more formal. That's the time when, I guess, Palmer Learn arrived to become executive vice chancellor and take over much of the administrative burdens off of him, plus academic duties. I think Palmer was quite involved.
Oh, yes.
Working with the Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs, and Vice Chancellor Student Affairs. By that time, we'd become fully blown, and everybody was a part of some procedure manual. We knew what everybody was doing. That was the impact that I saw Jim have